too fast.
Good morning. Welcome to our celebration today of the second Sunday in Ordinary Time. Could you take a moment, please, right now to turn off or mute any of your electronic devices? And please stand and greet your neighbors. In the readings today, we'll rehearse the baptism of the Lord. It's a day, a Sunday, when we look at God breaking through our limitations and makes his presence known among us. Our entrance song today is number 517, Praise to You, O Christ our Savior. We'll sing verses 2 and 3. Please join us.
With you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We first pause to recall our own weakness and sin, and again look to God as we open our hearts in mercy. Lord Jesus, you lift up the lowly. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You pardon the sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You heal the brokenhearted. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us all, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace.
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, on earth peace, to people of goodwill.
For you alone are the Holy One.
You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ.
Now the little lambs, after the prayer, let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Okay. Now it's time for the children to come up, the little lambs, I hear we call them, and very appropriately so. Good morning. Hi. Yeah, hi. Good. Yeah, you know, the Christmas time is over now. And remember at Christmas time, we were kind of looking and seeing baby Jesus. And now Christmas time is over, so now Jesus has grown up and gotten older. And we learn all about the older, the adult Jesus and all the good teachings he has for us, okay? So go in peace now.
The reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, the Lord says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is number 35, "Here I am, Lord." Please sing with us.
Here I am, Lord.
A reading from the beginning of the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle with Christ, Jesus, by the will of God, and Sosthenes, our brother, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to you who have been sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be holy, with all those everywhere who call upon the name of our Lord, Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Word of God became flesh and dwelt amongst us. To those who accepted him, he gave power to become children of God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to the Lord.
John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. He is the one of whom I said, 'A man is coming after me, who ranks ahead of me because he existed before me.' I did not know him, but the reason why I came baptizing with water was that he might be made known to Israel." John testified further, saying, "I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from heaven and remain upon him. I did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'On whomever you see the Spirit come down and remain, he is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Now I have seen and testified that he is the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's a great pleasure for me to be able to come back to visit St. Clair. For those of you who don't know me, or those of you trying to forget me, I'm Father Joe McCormick, Augustinian. I was pastor here some 20 years ago, and I happen to be here for the weekend, this weekend, for Father Fred Taggart's funeral yesterday. So I hung over a day, and Father Andrew gave me the opportunity to celebrate this Mass with you. I have to tell you, the place looks great, and I commend Father Andrew for the really great work and ministry that he has done here. But you're going to get a homily out of me. You know, I'm not much for watching the reality shows on TV, but there is one that I was thinking about that maybe you've seen, The Undercover Boss. Apparently, I think it's in its 13th season, so it's pretty popular. It's won a couple of Emmy Awards. And if you haven't seen it, the premise of the show is that the owner of a business or one of the top executives of a corporation takes on a disguise, and changes their appearance, takes on a false name, and then goes into one of their stores or restaurants or factories undercover at kind of the entry level. And they spend maybe a week or two as being an undercover worker in their own company. And of course, the purpose of it is for them to see how the company really works right at the grassroots level, to see how their employees are doing, see if the employees need any kind of additional support or resources, see how complaints are handled and all of that kind of thing. And then, of course, the show usually ends by the undercover boss. He goes back to his own offices or her own offices and invites in the people that he or she had been working with for those that week or 2 weeks that they were undercover. And very often they reward the employees, those that they found that were really doing good work. Sometimes they add some amenities, some benefits to the work of the employees. Sometimes they try to make other improvements based on their experience of being there in the restaurant or in the factory or in the store at that kind of entry level level. And I was thinking about that as I reflected on kind of where we are in our church year right now. As I mentioned to the little ones, Christmas is over, and all that focus that we have been giving to the baby Jesus, the infant Jesus, the birth of Jesus, now shifts. And we look to the grown-up Jesus, the adult Jesus. And it's John the Baptist in the gospel today who's saying, okay, I got to decrease, he's got to increase. So now, behold, there's the Lamb of God. Follow him. Serve him. Well, the spirit of the Baptist is in our church today, also pointing out where the Lamb of God is today. Where's the undercover boss today? So often we're told by Jesus himself that he, the Messiah, is present in the poor, in the helpless, the troubled, those challenged with all kinds of problems in life. Behold, the Lamb of God is there. Serve him. Show yourself as a beacon of goodness to him there. And of course, every time we as disciples of Jesus strive to really live the teachings that Christ gave us, the teachings about compassion, about justice, about reconciliation, every time we act in those ways, we are being Christ to others. And that's the call that each one of us has. And so as we listen again, maybe for one last time, to the voice of the Baptist in our church year, as he points us to Jesus, it's for us to look around and find, where is Jesus today in our midst? How can we serve him? Perhaps by serving those who are less fortunate, the poor, the underserved, those troubled in one way or another, and then be for them the light, the Christ that we are meant to be. Jesus doesn't want to be a boss in the sense of a bossy kind of person pushing us around, but he is present to us so often in disguise, and it's for us to recognize him and then serve him as he is and where he is today. Amen. Let us join together in professing our faith with our Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We look now to God who sent the Son, who takes away the sins of the world, and the Spirit who comes down on us in baptism and remains with us always.
We look now to God, who sent the Son, who takes away the sins of the world, and the Spirit, who comes down on us in baptism and remains with us always. Let us pray to the Lord. That the Church, by our prophetic words and our conscious efforts, may give witness to the continuing presence of the Holy Spirit in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders may resolve to pursue peace among the neighbors and rivals. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our church's missionaries, like Isaiah, Paul, and John the Baptist, they may testify to the light so God's word may be proclaimed everywhere. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may honor the memory of Reverend Martin Luther King, Jr., by courageously speaking out against injustice and working to bring about justice everywhere. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those experiencing difficulties, may they feel the support of our community and know our Stephen Ministry is available and ready to walk in faith with them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and seek our comfort and our prayers, Matthias Wilsowski, Valerie Albright, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially those bore witness to Christ in the midst of their suffering, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for Daniel Fredericks, Dolores Arsenault, Eleanor Genital, Lori Rashid, and the Weissner, Rigatti, Van Camp, and Smehall families, and Gail, Meggie, and Pestato. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Generous God, may your precious gift of the Son and Holy Spirit guide us as we put into action our love and mercy. Hear this and all of our prayers through your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Please join us now as we sing number 671. Number 671, Here I Am, Lord.
Sisters, brothers, all pray now that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord and Savior. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on that night he was betrayed, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy, this living sacrifice. O Lord, look upon the oblation of your church and see the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May Christ make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your saints, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Clare of Montefalco, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. O Lord, may the sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Alan, our bishop, and all the bishops, the clergy, and all who lead us in faith. Lord, listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have called before you. In your compassion, O merciful God, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admission to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. By the help of your mercy, may we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming again of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
The Lord Jesus Christ, you did say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my own peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins and failings, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We share with each other a sign of Christ's own peace. In the words of John the Baptist, "Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb." Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
This is Jesus.
Please join us now as we sing number 824, number 824, Behold the Lamb.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread one in mind and hearts. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
God bless us all.
Just a few announcements for today. Please join us for Encounter on Sunday evening, January 22nd, which includes adoration, a joyful mix of praise and worship music, traditional hymns, and an inspired talk given by Father Jim Lowe of the Companions of the Cross. Next, there are no religious education classes this weekend, so do something beautiful for God. Thank you all for your participation in our blood drive. We gathered 36 pints of blood were collected for all. And then finally, I know it's hard to imagine, but Lent is around the corner, and you'll see at the doors an invitation. It's all pink, and this is for a pre-Lenten tea. It's going to be February 5th at 1 to 3 o'clock in the social hall. So please pick up a flyer, take it home, and join us. Thank you.
Bow your heads, pray for God's blessing. May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen. Let us go now in the peace of our God.
Thanks be to God. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl around the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
And I want to say thank you to Father Joe for coming yesterday to celebrate the funeral mass for Father Fred and also for being with us today. So thank you. Safe travel home.
Please join us now as we sing number 710. Number 710, We Are Called.
Each other.